Hello, church. Welcome back to another episode of The Breakdown. We're so excited to have you here today. And what a great team I have here today. I'm so excited. So excited for these people here and these great leaders. And I want to invite you back to church in person every Sunday at 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. It's great. We're coming together. We're learning a lot from Pastor. And I'm just so excited to start today. So let's start on this side. You want to introduce a little bit about yourself? Tell us who you are and just how long you've been here at church.
All right. Well, my name is Katrina Phillips. Most folks here call me Miss K, but come on now.
Miss K in the
house. Hallelujah. Love the Lord. Love the Lord. I've been here for, I want to say June, May, 2 years. So I'm still relatively new, but I thank God for allowing me to find my way back home. I'm loving it. I'm growing. I'm developing and just having a good time in Jesus with my new family. Amen.
Awesome. New, but make an impact. Miss Kay, I wanted to ask you real quick. We're starting a new podcast here. Give us a little bit of the vision of what it is. I'm very excited about it. You're going to be leading it. So just share a little bit of the heart behind it.
Amen. It's going to be called Heart Rehab. Here at Heart Revolution, we believe in turning the hearts of children and families and, you know, getting people into their God-given potential and influencing our communities and our circles of influence. And with everything that's going on, every day is a heart rehab opportunity, right?
Right.
It's a heart issue. The Bible tells us to guard your heart with all diligence because out of it flows the issues of life. So we need to guard our hearts so that we can actually minister to that man, woman, boy, girl, to those children, to whomever it may be, so that we can make an impact in our community. The thing is, even though we're saved, life still isn't easy, right? When Jesus lost his cousin John, he wept. Come on, somebody.
Right.
When he went into the church and saw that they had turned it into a den of thieves, he got upset. Come on, somebody. He got frustrated when the apostles kept going to sleep. So we have emotions, and you know, we need just a simple reminder to just stay on top of things so that we can stay in alignment with him, so that this can stay in alignment with our community and our families.
Love it. I'm so excited. And who do we have on this side? Pastor.
Me, go Pastor ahead. Brittany. Yeah. I'm Pastor Brittany.
I don't want to spoil it. Pastor Brittany. I'm like, Pastor, go for
Woo!
It.
I have been here since 2013, since the end of 2013. Met my amazing husband. I'll let him introduce himself here. My heart was turned here. I mean, awesome. I left the adult industry and Jesus got a hold of my heart here.
Awesome.
And he's radically transformed my life. So I'm grateful to be here in this house.
Great. And you met this amazing man.
Handsome, honey.
Yes, God delivered me an angel right here at church at our young adult ministry.
Yeah.
Guys who don't know me, my name is Pastor Richard. I've been here since 2012.
Wow.
Moved from Santa Barbara to San Diego to serve right here at the Heart Revolution Church. And I believe that, you know, God called me here and I love it. I've been here for 8 years. Like I said, my wife said, I met her. We have a beautiful daughter named Jada Rose who just turned one. And
awesome.
God has been doing incredible things. And I just love being here. Love being a part of our community and our family. It's an honor to be here.
I love it. It's an honor to have all of you here. I'm super excited. And let's just jump in. Pastor Abe was talking about a message called Plan on Being Planted. And I believe there's a lot of things we can talk about. I love the analogies of being planted, of the trees and fruit. So we're going to get all through that. But let's open up with a verse. It's on Psalm 1:3. It says, they are like trees planted along the river, bearing fruit in every season. Their leaves never wither, and they will prosper in all they do. It's a great topic and a great message. And just to begin, you know, Pastor Abe was talking about being planted. When you go into the dirt, when you go into the darkness, you know, I believe that we all been in a season of our lives that we've just been buried, you know? And he was talking about the difference between being buried and being buried and being planted. We'll get to that later, but I just wanted to ask you guys just to start, you know, when was that season of your life where you felt buried, full of dirt and darkness? How was that season and how was that experience for you? Do you want to start, Ms. Kate? Do you have any experiences that...
Lord have mercy. I think we'd all count them up.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I do. I remember when the Lord was calling me, I had kind of been, I'd been shacking up for about 14 years and living my own life. And I remember when he was calling me out of it, and I literally walked away from everything to start over. And it was difficult.
Yeah.
It was difficult losing everything. I actually sent my daughter to go stay with her dad because I didn't really know how I was going to get through it. And so in that time, I mean, there were times that I felt like I was buried, right. You know, and I was like, oh, my God, why? But, you know, staying in the Word, fasting to try to deal with the flesh, understanding that, yes, that was his voice that called me out and I don't understand, but I'm going to keep going. You know, somewhere in that process, I realized I was actually planted.
Right.
And so, yeah, it was a very lonely time, but at the same time, it gave me such a faith and such a trust in him because he brought me through and no one else could get the credit. It was right. it was just me and him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So good.
That's powerful. How about this at you, pastors?
So just recently, you know, right before we had our daughter, I took on a mega ministry, my husband and I, Triple X Church.
Yeah.
And right after giving birth, it was like every desire that I had just changed. Like right. I was just craving maternity leave. I was craving being a mother. But because I had just taken on this ministry, I had to start working 4 days after giving birth.
Oh,
granted,
no.
I was working from home. But let me tell you, in that time, I truly felt like I had been buried.
Right.
Because here's God that has given me this amazing opportunity, yet every single day I started fighting him. Yeah. Every single day I woke up with anxiety because I didn't want to go work. I didn't want to go serve. I just wanted to be a mom. I wanted to forfeit my calling because this was like all I wanted.
Right.
And this season went on for about 9 months. I'm not joking. Every day, Rich can attest to this, I was miserable. Yeah. I woke up with chronic, and I'm not an anxious person, and this is just the battle that I was facing until, you know, my husband kept telling me, Brittany, you need to surrender. And I'm like, oh, like surrendering used to be so easy when I first became a Christian. I don't know why this is so hard. So one day I woke up, I was feeding my daughter breakfast, and I just said, I had all this anxiety. I said, enough is enough.
Yeah.
I put some praise and worship music on. I started praising, and I started rebuking the spirit of anxiety.
Yeah.
I started rebuking the spirit of depression. And it was like, this just started to break off of me. And I felt so free in that moment. And so there are times when you are, as a Christian, you are not, just as you were saying, you're not exempt from trials. You're not exempt from tests. You are going to go through some hard things, and you might feel like nobody around you understands because you see a lot of people when you come to church and we're joyful and we have a smile on our face. But hey, we are not exempt from the tests and trials. And if there is a call on your life, you better believe Satan's going to do what he can to try to wipe that away from you. So you cannot surrender to the enemy. You have to surrender to God, and you got to do some warfare at times when you feel like you've been buried.
Wow, that's awesome.
Hallelujah.
And I was talking to you a couple days ago. Get it? I was talking to you a couple days ago about it. Remember?
Yeah.
We were talking about how a couple Sundays ago I came to church, and a couple people, leaders and friends, a lot of people are dealing with anxiety. A lot of people are dealing with all these things, you know. And I feel like it's this season, especially this year, has been a year where the whole world is buried, you know.
Yeah.
But like you said, you know, we have to fight through. God has a plan, and that's awesome the way you put it, because it's in the normal. It's work, you know, just getting out of bed, getting doing the daily that sometimes is just very hard. Pastor Rich, how about you?
Yeah, I think for me, one of my most struggling years was in the beginning of 2014.
Yeah.
I was actually diagnosed with an autoimmune disease called alopecia.
Wow.
And, you know, I've always had a full set of hair. I've been, you know, I tried to kind of get my hair kind of looking like yours on that, you know, nice flow.
Why?
And, you know, I had nice, plentiful hair. It was amazing, you know. I mean, I should have been sponsored by Head & Shoulders, but it was incredible. But 2014 was probably one of my darkest years in my life. I come home from work. I jump in the shower. I put shampoo in my hair. And while I'm putting shampoo in my hair, I'm noticing that I have something in my hands. And what's in my hands is all my hair has fallen out.
Wow.
And I'm like, what's going on? I shake my hair, strands of it keep going.
Yeah.
And I go like this, and I rub my face. And I look, my eyebrows depleted. I get out of the shower. I am crying, literally bawling and looking in the mirror and I said, God, like, what are you doing? Like, what's happening here?
Right.
You know, we're talking about being planted. Yeah. God gave me a word in 2012 to come here. I am faithful. I'm being planted. I'm serving. I'm doing every ministry as possible here.
Yeah.
Doing young adult ministry. I'm PPNA for pastor. I'm doing greeting, Asphalt Angels, you name it. I was planted and I was faithful. But I don't know if this have ever been ever happened to you, but have you ever been faithful and felt like God has forsaken you?
Yeah. Yeah.
I felt like I was Joseph, faithful, yet I felt forsaken.
Right.
Because in this moment I was asking God, God, what did I do?
Yeah.
I think there's times in our lives where we're planted and we don't see fruitfulness, right? And we don't see ourselves, in fruition and growing. We start questioning God.
Right.
And in those moments, the enemy tried to put those doubts in my head. He tried to sow deceit in my mind.
Yeah.
And I remember that day, and it was that afternoon, I looked in the mirror with tears in my eyes and I said, God, I am not mad at you. I am not mad at you. If anything, I am madly in love with you.
Wow.
I will serve you. I will do whatever it takes. I will be planted in the house of the Lord because my love is not based off circumstances.
Yeah.
My love is based off the covenant and the relationship I have with you. So, Pog, on that Wednesday, Pat, one of our pastors asked if I could do greeting, and that's the day my hair. That day is when my hair fell. I'm like, no way, God. And God's like, are you still going to be faithful?
Wow.
And I said, I'm still going to be faithful. No one recognized me or noticed me coming in. It was an embarrassing. One guy, literally, one of the ushers said, is this the new style, Pastor Rich? Should I cut all my hair off? I'm like, no, if you have hair, save it. I wish I had mine.
But
it was in the moment that I stayed planted, and that's where God really does his greatest work. It's that internal work. God was growing something inside of me.
That's incredible.
I'm grateful for those dark moments, because those dark moments showed me the faithfulness of our God, and God has been faithful.
That's incredible. That's an amazing story. And the fact that you went that day must have been, I mean, one of the toughest days, you know?
Ever.
Wow, that's incredible. And and just based on that, you know, like, what? How do you know the difference between I'm not just buried alive, I'm planted? You know, you said that you told God, I'm madly in love with you.
Yeah.
But I just want to follow up with you in this next question.
Yeah.
Like, how did you know right there and then, God, you didn't just bury me, you planted me, and I know there's a future?
Yeah, absolutely. I think there's going to be times in our lives where there's going to be a sacrifice and a surrender.
Right.
And I felt in my life that God was calling me to bury things. And for instance, he was calling me to bury, you know, how I seen life. Because for me, prior before this, which you guys don't know, I was very performance-based. Like, outwardly, I needed to be on point. I needed to make sure I was a perfectionist.
Right.
So, to answer your question, God was bearing something, you know, for me, but he was also birthing something in me.
Yeah.
So I have to learn, if we want to learn the difference between that, we have to have a relationship with God. And that is the key, because if we want to be planted, if we want to flourish, I love what Pastor Abe said. He says, we need to be connected to that river.
Right.
In that river, you'll have discernment. You'll have understanding. So in that moment, God, it looked like I was buried, but God was like, no, you're just planted. Yes, I'm going to prune some things off of you because I am the gardener, and these things are not causing fruition in your life, but because you're willing to surrender and you're willing to sacrifice, I am going to do something that you have never seen before.
Wow.
So in those moments, we have to learn to trust the gardener.
Yeah.
How we trust the gardener is we learn to do it by being in his word.
Yeah.
If you don't, or if you're not in his word, you are going to question what he is trying to do.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's learning to be in his presence. This morning, I was in my word this morning, and there's the story that we're all familiar of. It's the feeding of the 5,000 with the five loaves and the two fish. And I love this text, because when the disciples jump on the boat, God is reminding them about the loaves. He is reminding them about the bread. Yep. And I thought about, wow, the bread. I want to make sure that when the storms of life hit me, that I'm reminded of the bread, of the yeah. word of God. That when life hits, I'm going to go back to the bread. I'm going to go back to the word, because that word is going to give me nutrients. That yeah. word is going to help me to depict and to decipher what is being planted in my life and yeah. what God is calling me to bury.
Awesome. Yep. Wow, Rich, that's powerful. Yeah. That's a word. That's it for today. No, that's awesome. And Pastor Brittany, just based on that, you know, like when you feel like you're buried, have you ever given God like a time frame? I don't know. You're laughing at it, so maybe you've been, but like, God, if you don't take me out of this, if I don't see fruit by this time, I'm out. What is your experience on that?
I laugh because although I have never personally given God a time frame, right. I think I just know better. I've counseled a lot of girls, a yeah. lot of women that do give God's time frames, you know, like, well, if God doesn't bring me a husband by yeah. this date, you know, yeah, yeah, or yeah. by next the year, then I'm going to yeah. start going back to the club because I'm right. sure I'll find a man there. But it's like, no, don't allow the lack of external blessing to tempt you to want to walk away and to leave God. Like, yeah. that's never the answer. You know what I mean? Like, in God, he promises us that our soul is going to prosper. And if we can continue to believe in him, then everything yeah. else flows from that. Right. So, no, I that's what I laugh for. But, yeah.
That's right. And how about you, Ms. Kay? Have you ever been through a moment that you felt like, okay, if I don't see fruit by this time, I'm just going to change my job, career, ministry, family, everything?
Oh, my gosh. No. I mean, maybe in my much younger salvation.
Right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But honestly, no. And it's simply because I think at this point in the game, I believe God.
Yeah.
I trust him.
Yeah.
You know, and so the fact that if he would allow a situation to bury me, then it's for me. It's right. something in that is supposed to develop me. Right. Even in the agricultural sense, come on, somebody. Mm-hmm. People actually pay money to have manure to fertilize yeah. their crops. Come on
right.
now.
Yeah.
Because there are important nutrients. So in the mess of life, yeah. there are nutrients that God will use in that to grow and develop us so that we can be strong. And so with that being said, you know, when you are buried, it's a mindset of whether or not you perceive you're buried or yeah. do you perceive that you're planted.
Right.
It is a mental mindset because the Bible says that my sheep know my voice and a stranger they will not follow.
Right.
So when I am buried, yes. I understand that God has planted me yes. because what the enemy meant for evil, God always yeah. flipping it for the good. Come yeah. on, somebody.
Yeah.
So when the enemy throw dirt on me to bury me, I get excited because I know God is actually is planting me.
Right.
And if I keep my mind right, and if I pray, and if I fast, and if I stay the course, guess what? I will be like the tree planted yeah. by the rivers of the water. Come on.
Right.
My leaves won't wither. Come on, I'm on, come on, come on, somebody.
You're on it.
So that's, you know, for me, I mean, but, you know, for those that are just trying to get this thing, I'm telling you, a lot of times we get saved and we feel like we got to lose our fight.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I remind people, look, if you was a fighter before you got saved, be a fighter right now.
Yeah.
Be a fighter. Don't lose that fight. Don't lose that tenacity. Don't lose it because you need that in this salvation. You yep. need that. So, you know, that's what I would say.
You gotta
to that.
Keep fighting. You can't become a Christian and stop fighting.
Yeah, amen. Absolutely.
If God gave you the fight, you gotta keep fighting, right?
That's a word.
Yeah, you can. If you yeah. was a fighter, it's time to keep fighting.
Let's fight go. For the Lord.
Let's
I love
go.
That. I love
Let's
that.
Go.
Come that speaks on. To me because I'm a fighter. Speaks to me. I'm gonna keep fighting.
Don't
now.
Lose your fight, Paco.
Come on.
Fight on this side. Get it.
Let's go. Let's
Preach.
Go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
EJ, let's go. So, Pastor A, we're about to fight right here. Put the ring. Spiritual ring, right?
Bring out the gloves.
Yeah. So Pastor A was talking about three thoughts about being planted. Number one was planned to win from within. And I know we've all mentioned it throughout this conversation, yeah. but you mentioned something right now with the crops and the nutrients that they plant. And I just want to go into it. And Pastor Richards, if you can help us. The point said in Psalm 1:3, we will be like trees and we'll be planted by the river.
Yeah.
God wants us to be planted by him. He's the river
Absolutely.
Of, you know, of nourishment. And if with him, we have forever blessings, right?
Absolutely.
But, you know, just like she said, sometimes we bring different nutrients into our lives. So has there ever been a point in your life that you just depended on a different source of nutrients? And how was those experiences, and how did you just turn it around to just have God as a source?
Yeah, I had to recognize that I was leaning on my own understanding.
Yeah.
And whenever you lean on your own understanding, there will always be questioning. There will always be lack of faith and lack of trust. When I understood I was getting anxious and I was questioning the Lord, it's because I wasn't drawing from Him. Mm-hmm. You see, everything changes when we draw from a different source.
Right.
So when you learn to draw from the right source, it gives you the right power. It gives you the right nutrients. So if we are going to win from within, that we need to be connected to the vine. The issue, I believe, Paco, is with our generation in this world today, is that we pick and choose how we should obey God.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. We pick and choose. We say to the word, I'll say yes to this, but I'll say no to this. I'll say yes to success, but I'll say no to sacrifice.
Wow.
And the struggle with that is if you have that type of mindset, you will never get the full nutritional value in which God is trying to do within you. Yeah. Not only that, God can't renew your mindset, shape the way that you think, shape the way that you view life.
Yeah.
So if we are going to see ourselves come into fruition, we need to stay connected to Him on an everyday basis. Okay.
Yeah.
It just can't be on Sunday listening to Pastor Abe's message and on Wednesday on the breakdown.
Yeah.
It has to be Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We need today's word for today's battle.
Yeah.
Oftentimes we get yesterday's word for today's battle, and you will never receive a breakthrough from yesterday's word.
Exactly.
We need today's revelation. We need today's wisdom. But how do we do that? We draw from the source every single day, every single morning. As Christians, it should not be an option to communicate with the Lord.
Yeah.
It should be an everyday thing. It's not an option for me to talk to my wife.
Right.
And if it was an option, she'd probably kick me out of the house, okay? Yep. It would be locked up. I wouldn't be able to get in. I'd be begging, praying outside, pleading the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
I would do whatever it took to get inside of the house.
Yeah.
But it's so funny because, like, God has a word for us. He has wisdom to help us in our situation.
Yeah.
And I think it's so funny because in that text, the plant gets that nutrition. I think sometimes if we're not careful, we try to find wisdom and nutrition through people, you know, through things, through social media. Oh, I'm going to listen to this pastor.
Yeah.
But what if God had the right word that was tailored to your situation, but you never sought after Him?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like if we're going to get today's word, then we need to be in the Word of God.
So
that's how we win from within.
Yeah.
I want to add to that too, because I like that you said to win from within, right? So that's the whole point, is like the our heart determines the course of our life, right?
Yeah.
So like back in my BC days, like I was very successful externally, but I was dying internally. And see, so many times we live in this world and in this generation where we're trying to get everything externally. If we can just drive a nice enough car, if we can just have enough money, if our house could be big enough, right?
Yeah.
And we strive for all of these things externally, but we fail to recognize that even when you get everything that you want externally, it's still not going to be enough if your soul is not being nourished by living water, right? And so we need the Spirit of God, because it doesn't matter what you get externally. If you're not winning internally, then you're still losing, even if you have everything externally. I used to make over $30,000 a month. I had hundreds of thousands of followers on Instagram and Twitter.
Yeah.
And guess what? None of that made me happy. None of that was enough. I was full of depression. I was bipolar. I had schizophrenia. I had all these different mental disorders that I was battling with. None of that made me happy. And so you have to win from within, and you're only going to get that by tapping into the source. You know, every day seek God through worship, through prayer, through reading the Bible. You know, do those three things every single day, and you're going to notice that you're going to be so full internally that you'll be like Paul when he's in the middle of a prison cell, and you can say, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Whether I have a lot or a little, I'm still fully content because I'm connected to the source.
That's great. And actually, that's our next point. You know, and I'm great. It's great that you touched on it, because point number two was plan to never surrender. It says you will bear fruit in each season, and your leaves will never wither. So, in that time that you said, you know, yeah, that you felt like your leaves were withering, how was that fight? You know, how did you feel? You know, God, you're gonna get me out of this, and now you're here. How was that process of fighting and not surrendering? Because we're talking about being a fighters, absolutely, right? Absolutely. And in that season, you know, how did you fight through?
Well, in that particular season, honestly, I was at the end of myself. I had truly hit rock bottom, that it wasn't a fight. I was desperate for God. I was hungry for God. I knew that if I took one more step in the direction that I wanted to go in, my life would have ended from drug addiction or suicide. I would have been done. Like, I wouldn't be here today. I wouldn't be married. I wouldn't have my beautiful daughter. Yeah. Like, my life would have been over. And so I was at the end of myself. And sometimes that's what we got to do. We got to get to the end of ourselves so that God can do what he wants to do in our lives, you know? Yeah. But in the season just last year, when I was fighting against God, and I had to choose not to surrender to my will anymore, because God didn't bless me with a daughter so that I could surrender my call and just go be a mom. I mean, God bless anybody that has a call to be a mom. That's an amazing call. But God has called me. He rescued me out of the porn industry so that I could go back there. And here I am fighting against him. So when I finally got to the place where I said, I want to surrender, and I did some warfare and I got to that place, I've tried my best to stay down that path. Now, of course, the enemy knows your weakness. He knows if it was once your battle, that he'll try to come in and tempt you with it again. Yeah. So it's what I call it, is a constant surrender. Yeah. We're constantly coming before the foot of the cross, and we're saying, hey, Jesus, like, I'm struggling with this again. I give it back to you. Yeah. And so it's constantly handing your desires back over to Jesus.
I love that constant surrender. You know, just a continuous battle. It's never going to end.
Absolutely.
It's never going to end. We're going to continue. And just for all of you, you know, like, we're talking about being fruitful. Sometimes we're giving it our best. We're in ministry. We're doing everything else. They call it the white picket fence and the one point, you know,
keeping up with the Joneses.
Yeah, you know, those pastor jokes. But how do you know in that process, you know, when you're giving it your best, how do you know that you're being fruitful? You know, do you guys have any, you know, references or reflections on a point in your life that you're giving it your best, but you don't really see the blessing? Or, like, how do you know that, okay, I see the fruit?
I think for me personally, the way I approach things.
Right.
So if I'm going through a tough season, yet I'm being patient with God, I'm showing love, kindness, the fruits of the Spirit.
Right.
I know that in that season, right then and there, that God is doing internal work with me, and I'm becoming fruitful.
Yeah.
You see, what happens to society is that we think success is shown on the outward things, right? Mm. Kind of like what Brittany said, the money, the fame, the cars, the followers, blah, blah, blah. But the reality is, the greatest fruit that we could ever see done in our lives is internally. So the fruits of the Spirit. So, for instance, going back to my story in 2014, when all my hair fell out, but I came to church with a smile on my face, serving with all of my heart.
Yeah.
People are looking at me like, shouldn't you be home right now, like, hiding and covering yourself? Because let's be honest here, most people would do that.
Right.
But because I was fruitful in every season, because God was pruning me and he was shaping me inside of me, I was able to approach that season well.
Right.
And I understand something about God, that God is a purposeful God. God does everything with purpose. And what happens to a lot of us is that when we're in different seasons, we don't understand the purpose, because we need to see an external fruitfulness or external work.
Yeah.
But the reality is that every season, there's a purpose behind it.
Right.
The reality is this: never leave your season without knowing the purpose behind that season.
Yeah.
Tell God in that season, God, what are you trying to show me? Stop telling God why and start asking God what.
Right.
What are you trying to show me?
Yeah.
What are you trying to do inside of me? Because when you get that revelation, you'll understand that you've been fruitful.
Yeah.
That look at the way that you come across things. Man, you got hit with sickness, yet you're still smiling and praising the Lord. Like, man, he broke up with you, she broke up with you, and you're still outside praising God. Like, why? Because I am fruitful in everything. every season. So for me personally, it would be attitude and my approach towards it. And when you live that way, oh, I'm telling you, that ministers to people, because people want to see you through tough times. Yeah. Any, you know, I mean, you preach the loudest, not through your brightest moments, but through your darkest moments. Wow. And in those dark times, that's when we're able to glorify God because of the fruit that is inside of us.
Wow, that's incredible, because like you said, sometimes people expect to see the fruit in like ministry, riches, or anything else, but it's the attitude. I love that. Yeah. Did you want to add to that?
I did. And not only just that, but also understand that, you know, Paul planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the increase. And so, you know, a lot of times when we're looking for fruit, understand this may be your planting season. You just may be planting seeds, you know, and maybe you won't be around to see it, you know, grow or pop through the ground, but just know you're a seed planter this season, you know, and maybe in this season you're water, you know, someone else planted and you're next up. You're watering with the word of God. You're watering by discipleship. You're watering through the family life groups. You're watering through your XXX ministries. You're watering through, come on somebody, through the dream team. You're watering. And then, you know, at some point, then the fruit will come to pass. But, you know, I think, you know, in regards to fruit being bared, one of the biggest things that I agree with is the fruits of the Spirit within us. Because when the fruits of the Spirit within us, that's really all we should be concerned about, right?
Right.
I mean, it's God, no matter what, it'd be nice to see something on the external happen because of something you told me to do, God. But I'm reminded, hallelujah, Holy Ghost, thank you.
Yeah.
I'm reminded of the book of Hebrews. Come on, somebody. Yeah. You know, the faith chapter. Come on, 11. Yeah. You know, the so many people, you know, walked out and was faithful and never saw the promise come to pass, but they kept it moving. Come on, somebody. Yeah. So that you know, to bring that home, you know, sometimes you're in a planting, sometimes you're in the water. And if you don't know, just God, fix my fruits of the Spirit. Fix me. Come on, somebody.
That's awesome. And just to close up, Pastor Brittany, how can you encourage someone who feels they're buried? You know, how can you encourage them at home and they just don't see the fruit? They don't even know they're bringing roots. You know, they don't have any church friends. Nobody's invited them. How do you encourage them to be like, hey, this season of being underground, it's a good season?
Yeah, I would say, honestly, you are in such a great season, and you do have to change your perspective to recognize that you are not just buried, that you are planted, that anything and anyone that God has his hand on is bound to flourish. So just get through this season, persevere, surrender to the Spirit of God, seek him on a daily basis, pray, worship, read your Bible, really, truly get to know God's heart for you in this season. And I promise you, you are going to come out of this season better and stronger than before, because every season is a season that is bound to teach you something. So there are lessons in this season that are extremely valuable that you are going to need. You're going to need to apply these lessons that you're learning in your next season. So learn everything that you can during these hard times and recognize that God has thrown you in the dirt because he has plans to flourish you.
Awesome. Well, that was great. That was great. I'm so thankful that you guys were here. I'm so happy that you guys can make it. It was such a great message for this team. You know, like, I believe that you guys' experiences and ministries itself just reflect, you know, what the word of Pastor A brought on Sunday. And I just want to thank everyone at home. Thank you so much for tuning in today. We wait for you here on Sunday at 9 a.m. and at 11. Come through, get planted in the house. There's so much here to grow with. And check us out again next Wednesday at 7 p.m. on The Breakdown. We love you, family. We'll see you guys next time.